Many thanks to those listeners who wrote in appreciation of our archives tribute to Marion Finucane last week. In fact, there had been such extensive coverage on Morning Ireland and on the Today with Sean O'Rourke programme on Friday and again on her own programme on Saturday from 11 to 1, that it was difficult to avoid duplication. And I'm certain we did not avoid it. But that said, some listeners expressed disappointment that we curtailed the Marion Finucane interview with Luciano Pavarotti, which dated from 1999. We just included the Irish connections, his breakthrough in the early 1960s when he was spotted in the Italian season of the Dublin Grand Opera Society.
So John Ingpen, who was the artistic director of Covent Garden at that time, she came to Dublin, she heard me in Rigoletto, and then she booked me for the first four performances and to cover Mr. Di Stefano.
And the rest, as they say, is history.
And I was really all over around the world.
Nor did we include any example of his own extraordinary voice. Indeed, on the original programme, Marion Finucane had this to say about his popularising of this song when it was used in Italian 90 on all the television coverage worldwide.
Without a shadow of a doubt, the World Cup 1990, the three tenors, the decision to go populist, the decision to sing that one particular song as the anthem of that year was, I suppose, the carrying card into the future of Luciano Pavarotti.
And we also included last week his interest in Irish horses.
And they brought me to Irish Kellett.
Mm-hmm. In Kildare.
Yeah, it was so good, so incredible that I say, I'm going to send my three daughters to Ireland to learn how to go on the horse.
But as some listeners have reminded me, the interview continued beyond these two topics, and we can now hear the rest of it. Concerned with fame, with privacy, subjects on which Marion Finucane had her own views.
To come on to the music and the life of a tenor and an opera singer, to the outsider, describe the life. Is it a difficult life? Is it a wonderful life? Is it a tense life? Is it a hard-working life?
Everything you have said. Is exactly everything you have said. It's difficult, it's delightful, it's charming, it's every good quality, but the only defect is that it's difficult. You must be persistent, strong in the decision and take it, the decision. Even when you are a student, you have to take one way and push on that direction without having any doubt, because singing opera is something very different than singing normally in the shower. So to construct the voice like that, you must really have faith in what you are doing.
Do you sing in the shower?
No, I whistle.
All right, okay. When...
You believe I'm whistling in the shower?
Well, if you tell me...
You cannot whistle in the shower.
Can you not whistle in the shower? Okay, I believe you. Do you sing in the shower then? You do?
No, I don't.
No, you don't.
No.
Okay. You said at one stage that it was important to be good at the job, but that it was also important to be famous. Why?
It's something will happen. It's not important to be famous. You will become famous if you are good. I remember once we were recording Bohème with Maestro Carian, with Freni. We were all there talking. We were young young, all going to the money, let's say. And we were talking, I am paid this, I am paid that, I should be paid that. And while we were talking, Mr. Carrier was behind us. And he says, be good in singing and you will be paid what you want. In my case, it was not much at that time, it's true. If you are good, you become famous. It's not important to be famous.
Well, perhaps that is partially true, but not completely, because there's also the quality of showmanship that is, I would think, not everybody has the same degree of showmanship, shall we say.
Well, let's say one thing. I am a big advantage. You see me once, you cannot confuse me with another the next time. So that is already
Why is that? We are on the radio.
So you mean why is that? Because I'm very chubby, I have a big beard, so you don't confuse me with another.
There is an image about opera that it is for the cognoscenti or for a very elite audience. And it seems to me that you have put a lot of effort, single-mindedly, into popularizing it.
I hope.
Yeah.
I hope. I have taken a big risk to come out from the theater, who generally contain 2,000, maximum 2,000 people, in Italy at least, and going to 10,000, 20,000, until half a million in New York, the open air, is a big risk, but is a great gratification for me, because most of the people, they learn what is opera from the arias, and most of the people, then they love opera, they know that there can be even some song. The song I sang by myself, I will do even the day after tomorrow, they are pop song of the year 30, 20, 40. So at that time, that were a popular song. Mm.
The charity War Child has been a special project of yours. How did that start?
Well, it started with Bono. Bono and Brian Eno. Brian Eno was the patron of War Child. And that year, I really want Bono on the show. If Bono is going to be on the show, I say to myself, and it was true, we are going to begin something very good for the future. He was not coming. All the telephone call, he was very nice, but very reluctant. And very, no, Mr. Pavarotti, don't come. So one day I took a plane from London and we went to Dublin. I say, Mr. Bono, guess what I'm doing tomorrow? So we were there, and from there he said that he's coming. And the next question is, we want to do something benefits. Mm. For whom should we make the benefit? And he said, Brian Eno is the patron of World Child, one of the patron of World Child. So we begin to do for World Child, and I think we have done until last year. Perhaps one day we will change, because you cannot do always for the same thing. But it's very good.
Because you were, in a way, a war child yourself, in that you experienced bombing in Modena when you were a child.
I think so.
Can you recall it?
Of course. I remember when the war began. I was at the dentist with my grandmother and my sister, and she was just born, 1940, something. She was 40, 41, when they declared the war. And from there, we begin to go home in panic. And instead to stay in the city, we went out in the country, living in the house of the countryman. Then he's giving us two rooms for 10 people, I think. It was, for me, was a good experience, because I learned to do everything a countryman does. I milked the cow. I went in front of the cow, because at that time they used the cow. It's not a tractor.
Or the plow.
Time. Yes.
Right.
Two cow. One horse, and I was in front to move around,
right,
while the countryman was there with the thing. For me, it was good. The only thing was not good is then we choose the wrong place to go, because every night Deutsch people and partisans, they're coming to visit us. And I remember very well the sound of the gun machine all the night long.
Can you remember being terrified?
Yeah, I have seen dead people, hung people when I was a kid. I was scared.
Nice.
But in the meantime, you know, the kid has inside this kind of desire of adventure. Then how tough it is, I'm talking about sensible and sensitive boy, how tough it is, there is always some power generated from the inside and it won't make you leave. It was a beautiful experience because all the people of my generation, they are optimistic, they know what is life, and they know that life is life. Life is not complication like people is looking for. It's life. It's a beautiful sunny day like today, love, and so, and so, and so. And the glass is always half full.
Okay, one last question. There are many advantages to being Luciano Pavarotti, and everybody loves you and they want you to come and they will be delighted to hear you in Belfast, certainly at Stormont. There are downsides to it too, in that people know everything about, or seem to know everything about your private life. How does that impinge on you?
They want to know something about my private life. But let's say that my private life, it was never clear like it is in the last 5 years. Because I'm living with Nicoletta, I'm super faithful. We are together 24 hours a day, you cannot even if you want, but I don't. I am completely in love. I declare that we separate with my wife because we both want that, so it's nothing dramatic. My private life is, I go to Monte Carlo with Nicoletta when I really want to be private. I go to Italy at the beach, and I am approximately private.
Luciano Pavarotti talking with Marion Finucane in 1999.